Whoa, yeah, swear to God I'm with it. I don't see nobody in my lane, it's quite go get it like me. Whoa, please don't be wasting my time with that business. Who you kidding, man? Yeah.
All right, guys, what's happening? Welcome back to the channel, and welcome back to another bodybuilding prep Q&A type video. I don't know how long this one's going to go for, but the last one went for fucking ages. I just couldn't stop speaking. I've been waiting to make these videos for a fair while. I spent the last 2 weeks post-show feeling like absolute shit because I'd felt like I'd thrown away all of the work that I did to get to 5% body fat by binging for 11 days straight. What I've done since then is actually bring it back. I've brought my physique back from the dead, and we're back, honestly, probably at about 6 or 7% body fat right now. And I feel fucking great about it. Because to lose that condition that you put so much effort in for so many weeks, so easily, it's depression. It is literally, I mean, if that doesn't affect you negatively, like really seriously negatively, then you are an extremely mentally strong person. I feel like I'm mentally strong, but I wasn't that strong. But I was strong enough to bring it back. Anyways, guys, today's video, the question is how I got to 5% body fat eating over 3,000 calories per day. And I was. I ate over 3,000 calories per day every single day of my bodybuilding prep until the last week of each of the shows. So, you know, food was fuel. I saw food as fuel. My expenditure was really, really high. And so before I get into anything, I think I've just answered the question. For those of you who want the question, want the answer straight up instead of watching the whole video, how did I get to 5% body fat whilst consuming over 3,000 calories per day when a lot of people say that's impossible? Cardio. It was calories burnt. If you're burning more calories per day than you take in, you're going to get leaner. So why are these guys on 1,800 calories to get to 5% body fat? It's because they're fucking sitting on the couch all day, except for their gym workout. Guys, food is fuel. If you're at 5% body fat, you can be consuming over 3,000 calories and burning all of that every single day and maintain 5% body fat. Yes, your joints are going to feel a little bit shit at times. Yes, your strength is going to be down. But if it's your goal to be at 5% body fat whilst eating a decent amount of calories, it's fucking possible. And I'm here to tell you how I did it. So this cardio expenditure wasn't always the case, guys. In fact, in the last 6 months, my mentality has shifted. It really has. It's shifted from only wanting to exercise, only wanting to walk or run to burn calories, rather than actually enjoying the walk or run for what it is and getting, you know, the added effect of burning calories as well. That's how my mentality changed throughout this. So I'm going out there just enjoying cardio for what it is, but at the end of the day, looking at my Fitbit and going, fuck, I've burnt 4,500 calories today. And that's how it happened. So as far as the forms of cardio that I did, I was playing rugby. So I had 2 trainings a week plus the game. Now that didn't last for the entire time, so that was just at the start. I also attended the NZIS, which is the New Zealand Institute of Sport, 5 days a week. We did cardio 3 days a week and 2 weight trainings. I also did weight training 5 to 6 times a week for 45 minutes to an hour. I also did an hour's cardio in the morning, every single morning. So you can see quite easily that if my calories weren't as high as what they were, not that I knew how many calories I was taking in, I wasn't tracking anything, but if I wasn't taking in the amount of food that I did, you know, I'd be fucking dying throughout these sessions, especially with the fact that I was very lean. Okay, so weight training was tough. Now, if I didn't take those calories in, my performance would drop. Whether it's placebo or not, my performance would drop over time. So my calories needed to be high. And they fueled my body. You know, my body didn't flatten out completely throughout this. You know, I had carbs always running through my system. When you go with a low carbohydrate diet for a long period of time, you know, a week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, performance suffers, man. It really does. But if you can get through it, it's certainly possible, but as a natural bodybuilder with no added testosterone, it's not easy. Anyways, So loads of cardio, and basically that's the answer. Like I said, the cardio ramped up over time, so I first started making sure that I hit 10,000 steps per day. Then I began doing 15,000 steps per day. You know, when rugby came into it, I was doing 20,000 steps per day. Take rugby out, back down to 15, bring the NZIS in, man, I was up at 25,000 steps someday. Like, my cardio output was crazy, and that's why, you know, I got to 5% body fat. Without this show, even if I wasn't doing a bodybuilding show, I firmly believe that with what I was doing and the way I was feeling and a good mindset, I would have got lean anyway. And that's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. So you don't need to go 1800 calories and starve yourself. You don't need to go completely low carb, and you don't need to have a bodybuilding show in mind to get to 5% body fat. So my calories burnt, you know, on an average day was over 4,000. So that meant that for me to effectively put on body fat, I had to consume over 4,000 calories per day. And I did some days. I'm not going to lie. I fucking did. I'd come home after a big day and a big training session, and I would just feel flat and depleted and know that I had to get up the next morning and do it again. I would eat 400 grams of carbohydrates. I would. Because my glycogen stores need them. And I need them. And I'd wake up the next morning with veins up my stomach thinking, well, that wasn't too bad. You know what I mean? It wasn't that bad. Okay, so you can, as long as you're consistent, it's all good. Obviously, 25,000 steps per day is a fuckload. And it's not sustainable, it's not. So cardio eventually has to come down, or you have to take breaks. So, you know, it isn't sustainable. But if that was to happen and I wasn't tracking anything, and I knew that my cardio was coming down, well, I'd reduce my carbohydrates, I'd reduce my food intake, I'd continue looking in the mirror, continue looking at certain lines, you know, certain striations, and if they start going away, I know I'm putting on a bit of body fat, and I'll just rein it back. You know, it's, we've all got two eyes, guys, let's use them, you know what I mean? I love my analytics, I love my stats, I'm not going to lie, but we've all got two eyes. So 5% body fat, look, overall is not a normal range of body fat. You feel it. In fact, I probably didn't feel it until I got to about 5.5% to 6% body fat. And then when you do wake up in the morning, it doesn't matter if you have a coffee, it doesn't matter if you smash back carbohydrates. A couple of hours after getting up, you sort of feel that fatigue coming on. And it's frustrating, but you know you've got to push through. It's frustrating. The only thing you can do is fuel up as much as you can, but not too much. Because obviously there's a fine line. When you're at 5% body fat, and you want to maintain or get leaner, there is a real fine line as far as how many calories, you know, you can take in. I mean, if your calorie expenditure goes down by a slight bit and you up your calories by a slight bit, you can tell, you know, you can see it in the mirror. It doesn't take too long, but it's all about being consistent, and everything's possible. So that's how I got to 5% body fat whilst eating over 3,000 calories per day. In fact, some days I would have eaten over 4,000, but it's only because I needed it. You know, and this goes back to Michael Phelps, an Olympic athlete, training hours and hours a day. Lean as fuck. In fact, he was probably leaner than I was on stage. And he ate 10,000 calories a day. Okay? Because he needed them. And I'll leave you with that. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. There's a few more to come in this series, and I'm enjoying them. This is a subject that I love, you know, bodybuilding, nutrition especially, and the ability to change your body's composition through a strategy. And this was mine. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video, and I will see you in the next one. Peace out.